So, again, Mr. Saunders, you had said that you talked to your brother after you got arrested?
Yeah, we always in there just talking about arrest. And then, like I said, everything little changed when he said that he took the money.
And did your brother tell you that he got arrested after you took drugs and money from the girlfriend of an inmate?
We didn't get into that.
You didn't get into it? So you talked about the charges. He never told you what the allegations are?
We started talking about the charges, and then he started talking about the money. All I heard was, I can't get my $1,200. And that was enough for me. I left.
So all you were interested in is getting your $1,200 back? So the fact that he had those things on him when he got arrested, whether it's marijuana or other items that he got from an inmate's girlfriend, you weren't concerned about that?
I don't know.
You didn't care? Is that a no?
No, I didn't care. Honestly, I didn't care.
And you were asked if you, in the past, have been charged with a crime. What crime were you charged with? You said to Mr. Thompson that you had been charged with a crime. What crime is that?
I was charged a couple of times. One was domestic with my ex-wife.
Did that go to trial?
Went to trial.
Right. And you were acquitted at trial?
Yes.
And were you charged after that with a different crime?
Yes.
And what's that?
Aggravated assault. Aggravated assault. That didn't go to trial. That went to the grand jury, and the grand jury would have been indicted.
Notice the Camden grand jury?
Camden grand jury. And then after that, that's when I won my appeal. That's how I became a police officer.
So after all that, you became a police officer?
I became a police officer. I should have became one in 06. I should have became one in 96. But I didn't get hired until 06. So when I got hired, they had to backdate all my time. So when I walked on the police force, even though I was there for 1 month, I had 1 month, 2 years.
So just before I sit down, I'm just going to ask you one more time. Your brother shows up at this rental property that you're working at, and he asks you for money on a trip that you're not going to, and you gave him $1,200. That's correct, right?
Correct.
If you're willing to do that, wouldn't you be willing to come in here and tell a story to help your brother out?
Not a story.
A story about giving him $1,200?
That's true. I don't tell a story.
Well, your brother might need your help, won't he?
I'm not going to mess with my pension, bro. That's the lie.
No further questions, Your
Honor. Mr. Saunders, how would that help? How would your testifying, quote unquote, mess up your pension?
Well, if you get court lined and stuff like that, you'd be charged. If I'm charged, you get court lined.
And how would it be determined that you were lying?
If what I'm saying is not true.
How would that be determined?
Well, he's saying that, well, basically he's saying is that if I'm in court lying.
How would you get caught lying?
I don't know.
You said you gave him money.
Yeah, I gave him money.
Right.
That's
well,
what I
did. Video, there's no receipts or something like that, right?
No, I just gave him money.
Well, then how would you get caught lying?
No, he said that would I lie for my brother? I'm not going to lie for nobody. I'm not going to mess with my money.
Right, but how would it be shown that you were lying, based on what you said?
Okay, you can.
And your brother was at the time when he wanted money was full-time employed?
Yes.
Do you know how long he'd been full-time employed?
We started around the same time. We both started. He started corrections in 06, and I started in 06, and we started around the same time.
So he was full-time employed as a corrections officer?
Yes.
But you had to help out with mortgage and things like that from time to time?
I had to mortgage when he was laid off. I don't know what's mortgage. Other than that, sometimes he might get, he needed a couple of dollars to help him with some gas bills.
Would you know your brother to be in need of money from time to time?
No. He don't ask me like a lot of questions about money all the time.
Do you know why he needed the money for the trip?
He just wanted to spend the money. He wanted somebody to spend the money.
And did you know if anybody else had given him any money?
Didn't ask.
Well, for the record, apparently there was a woman who gave him $1,000. Her name, Tamara Hudson, you ever heard of her? And you gave him $1,200?
$1,200.
Did he say how much spending money he wanted?
No, I didn't. I didn't know what the other girl gave him money. I found out later on the other girl gave him money.
He didn't tell you that?
No, my
when he was asking you for money, did he say
can I be heard sidebar, please? Can I be heard sidebar?
Sure.